We are discussing in details about RAM memory or structure of RAM memory. As we are discussing, whenever any program is executed, program will be loaded from hard disk to RAM memory. RAM is a physical device which is, it has two logical partitions, external memory or residence memory. Here we are discussing in details about residence memory of the RAM. For executing or managing every C program, there is a 1 MB space will be resides inside RAM forever. Regarding executing any C program, whenever we are executing any C program, programs ko manage karne ke respect mein RAM memory ke andar always 1 MB space manage hota hai. 1 MB space ko name denge as a residence memory. Or size of residence memory depends upon memory models. Here we are discussing standard size. According to small memory models, RAM memory inside RAM residence memory will take 1 MB space. What is the size of residence memory area? Size of residence memory area is always 1 MB. Here we are discussing residence memory throughout this diagram. This residence memory will be divided into 16 equal segments. Internally, residence memory will be divided into 16 equal segments. Like that, segment 0, segment 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Next segment is called as segment A, segment B, segment C, D, E, and finally F. There are 16 segments are available with equal size inside residence memory area. As we are discussing, 1 MB space is equivalent to 1024 KB or kilobytes. In residence memory ko kilobytes mein represent karein, total size ka 1024 kilobytes. But what is the size of single segment or each segment? It is divided by 16 because we want to dividing it, that whole residence area, into 16 equal segments. It is equivalent to 64 KB. What is the size of one segment? It is a size of single segment. Every segment will take 64 KB space inside RAM memory. What is the use of different segments? Segment F, or we can say it is equivalent to segment 15. It will store information about ROM. Same as segment E, it will store information about BIOS setting. Here we are not interested in discussing segment E or segment F. We want to discussing in details about data segment. What is mean by data segment memory? Data segment memory is nothing but it is a 8th segment of residence area. Inside residence area, 8th segment is considered as data segment. As we are discussing, every segments are divided into 16 equal size, equal blocks. What is the size of one segment? 64 KB. अगर आप सेम इस केस में 64 KB को और bytes में convert करें, what is the equivalent size of each segment in bytes? You want to convert in this memory in the form of bytes, therefore we are multiplying by 1024. It is equivalent to 65536 bytes. This is the actual size of each segment. In सभी केस में segments कितने bytes में divide होंगे? 65536. Like that, segment 0, here is the first byte, second byte, third byte, and so on, last bytes or remaining bytes, like that. Address of first byte will be starts from 0, address of second byte starts from 1, 2, up to. What is the address of last byte? Address of last byte is 65536. Address of 535. Address of his last byte is 65535. Means 65535. Previous byte ka address kya hua iske isme 65534, like that, and so on. Same as in next segment also, we are providing same address. Address of first byte of segment 1 is 0, 1, 2 and so on up to 65535. Means सभी केस में सभी segments के केस में memory addressing कैसे हैं? Exactly same memory addressing. Then how to identify any memory place? Suppose that अब कोई middle location है with address having address as 100. Same as some address 100 address के केस में आता है any address. इस 100 segment 0 में भी exist करा, segment 1 के अंदर भी exist करा, segment 2, segment 3 in each segment that how to identify any byte uniquely. Any byte can be identified with the sequence of segment address and byte address, or we can say offset address. If you want to uniquely identify that place, what is the segment address? 001. What is the byte address or offset address? 100. Byte address or offset address is 100. Same in that case, segment address is 0, byte address is or offset address is 100, like that. We want to discussing in details about data segment. Data segment is a 8th segment of residence memory, which is divided into again 4 sessions. Data segment again divided into 4 sessions. First session is considered as data area. This one is data area. Next segment is considered as logically heap area. Next one, third session of data segment is considered as method area. Last session of data segment is considered as stack area. Stack is nothing but it is a last session of data segments, like that. As we know, address of data segment is all, what is the size of data segment? Size of data segment is also 65536 bytes. Then first byte ka address kya was kisna? Again 0. Next byte ka address kya? 1, 2, 3 up to address of last byte is always 65535 and so on, like that. Here we want to discussing what is mean by data area, what is mean by heap area, method area, stack area, like that. Whenever any C program got executed, in that case, executions ke respect mein, total case mein mujhe discuss kya karna hai? How many types of sessions are available? 8th segment is nothing but it is a data segment. In that case, data segment. First one, for discussing different phases of this program, we want to discussing some program. This is a particular case ko practically implement karne ke liye code write karna, like some C program which is available inside hard disk memory in the form of some file called as a.c file. We are discussing some functions like a void m1 some function or code with some required logics, same as void m2 some required logics, like that. Same as some function, as we know, execution of C program will be starts from main function, some logics of the main function. Here we want to discussing or creating some variables like a integer x, then a static int y. Next one, you want to creating some memory space by using malloc functions. We are discussing details what is mean by malloc or like that, some other property like that. Whenever this program is executed, as we know, every program will be loaded from hard disk to RAM memory. Hard disk to RAM memory. This is whole partition of RAM. As we are discussing, whole RAM is divided into two sessions, external RAM or residence memory. Here this segment or this whole residence is a part of RAM memory. Inside RAM, RAM internally divided means 8 segment of residence memory is considered as data segment. Again we are exploring here. Whenever this program is executed, as we know, whenever this program is compiled, how many? Yes, program ko compile karenge, to compilation ke respect mein create kiya one more file called as exe file. Executed file mein store hua एग्जीक्यूटिव इंस्ट्रक्शन अबाउट फंक्शन एम वन मीन्स फंक्शन एम वन के रिस्पेक्ट में स्टोर किया हो रहा है सम एग्जीक्यूटिव कोड और मशीन कोड सेम एज एग्जीक्यूटिव कोड फॉर एम टू एग्जीक्यूटिवल कोड फॉर मैन फंक्शन लाइक दैट एंड सो ऑन मीन्स दिस एग्जीक्यूटिव फाइल कंटेंस मशीन कोड अबाउट एम वन एम टू और मैन फंक्शन नेक्स्ट वेन एवर वाट इज दिस सेशन सेशन वन अकॉर्डिंग टू डायग्राम This one is a data area. We are discussing what is the use of data area, what is the use of heap area, what is the use of method area, similarly what is the use of stack memory. Throughout C programming, we are every time using stack memory. Therefore, beginning of the program, we want to discuss in details what is the exact structure or memory representation of different session of the data segments. Because जब भी आप C program execute कराओ, C programs के अंदर different types के variables create करेंगे. Different types के various category wise, different locations में create होंगे. Therefore, we want to discuss in details about that locations. What is the use of data area? First of all, whenever this program is executed, program is loaded from hard disk to RAM. इसे initial process क्या perform हुआ इस केस में loading process. Whenever any C program is got executed, executable code will be loaded inside method area. इस particular केस में जैसे इस प्रोग्राम का एग्जीक्यूशन स्टार्ट करें तो एग्जीक्यूशन के रिस्पेक्ट में लोडिंग किसके लिए हो रहा है एग्जीक्यूटिव कोड ऑफ एम वन एग्जीक्यूटिव कोड ऑफ एम टू एग्जीक्यूटिव कोड ऑफ मैन फंक्शंस लाइक दैट एग्जीक्यूटिव कोड ऑफ एनी प्रोग्राम विल बी लोडेड ऑलवेज इनसाइड मेथड एरिया दिस इज द यूज ऑफ मेथड एरिया इनसाइड रेसिडेंस मेमोरी एज वी आर डिस्कसिंग किसी भी प्रोग्राम को एग्जीक्यूट करने के रिस्पेक्ट में ऑलवेज रैम मेमोरी के अंदर 1 एमबी स्पेस परमानेंटली रिजर्व रहता है फॉर एवर दिस इज परमानेंट मेमोरी एग्जिस्टेंस इज कंसीडर्ड एज रेसिडेंस मेमोरी विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मैनेजिंग सी प्रोग्राम्स इन दैट केस रेसिडेंस मेमोरी अगेन डिवाइड इंटू 16 इक्वल सेगमेंट्स हियर 8th सेगमेंट इज कंसीडर्ड एज डेटा सेगमेंट वेन एवर एनी प्रोग्राम इज लोडेड फ्रॉम हार्ड डिस्क टू रैम लोडिंग के रिस्पेक्ट में परफॉर्म लोडिंग किसके लिए करा हुआ है फॉर मशीन कोड और कंपाइल कोड ऑफ द प्रोग्राम कंपाइल कोड ऑफ एवरी प्रोग्राम बी लोडेड इनसाइड मेथड एरिया देयरफॉर वी आर स्टोरिंग कंपाइल कोड ऑफ एम वन कंपाइल कोड ऑफ एम टू मैन मीन्स दिस कोड इज नथिंग बट इट इज अ एग्जीक्यूटिव कोड और मशीन कोड विल बी लोडेड इनसाइड मेथड एरिया नेक्स्ट वन आफ्टर दैट एग्जीक्यूशन इज बिगिन एज वी नो एग्जीक्यूशन विल बी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम मैन फंक्शन जैसे इस केस में मैन फंक्शन का एग्जीक्यूशन स्टार्ट हुआ सबसे पहले परफॉर्म क्या हुआ एलोकेशन फॉर वेरिएबल एक्स वी आर डिस्कसिंग लेटर डिफॉल्ट स्टोरेज क्लास ऑफ इंटीजर लोकल वेरिएबल इज ऑटो ऑल ऑटो वेरिएबल्स हियर वी वांट टू डिस्कसिंग थ्री डिफरेंट प्लेसेस मीन्स किस प्लेस पर किस टाइप के वेरिएबल्स क्रिएट होंगे अगर आपने कोई भी लोकल वेरिएबल क्रिएट किया तो बाय डिफॉल्ट लोकल वेरिएबल का स्टोरेज क्लास यूज होता है ऑटो हियर वी आर राइटिंग स्टोरेज क्लास एज स्टैटिक ऑल ऑटो वेरिएबल्स और लोकल वेरिएबल्स हैविंग स्टोरेज क्लास एज ऑटो क्रिएटेड इनसाइड स्टैक मेमोरी हियर एक्स इज अ ऑटो वेरिएबल्स देयरफॉर एक्स इज क्रिएटेड इनसाइड स्टैक ऑल मेमोरी एलोकेशन विल बी मैनेज्ड लाइक दैट हियर सम प्लेस used to some middle place is allocated for variable x like that maybe having address something 65524 like that means all auto variables created inside stack memory or simply we can say all local variables created inside stack memory here we are next one second case y is a static variable all static and global variables are created outside functions All static or external variables are created inside data area. Therefore, y is created inside data area. Means different types of variables category wise different places for manage होंगे. Next one, whenever memory space is allocated dynamically by using malloc function. अगर आपने memory space malloc functions के through allocate करा, इसके इसमें कितने bytes allocated किए? 2 bytes. This 2 byte space will be allocated inside heap memory which is created by using malloc functions or dynamically this is the purpose of dividing different session inside data segment means jab bhi kisi program ko execute karein program ke respect mein instructions load honge inside डेटा सेगमेंट टोटली फोर सेशन में डिवाइड हुआ, डेटा एरिया, हीप एरिया, मेथड एरिया एंड स्टैक एरिया। व्हाट इज द यूज ऑफ डेटा एरिया? ऑल स्टैटिक एंड एक्सटर्नल और ग्लोबल वेरिएबल्स आर क्रिएटेड इनसाइड डेटा एरिया। ऑल डायनेमिक मेमोरी एलोकेशन इज डन बाय यूजिंग मैलॉक और कैलॉक और रियलॉक फंक्शन बी एलोकेटेड इनसाइड हीप मेमोरी। ऑल एग्जीक्यूटिव इंस्ट्रक्शंस और कंपाइल कोड विल बी लोडेड इनसाइड मेथड एरिया। ऑल लोकल वेरिएबल्स और ऑटो वेरिएबल्स क्रिएटेड इनसाइड स्टैक एरिया। दिस इज ऑल अबाउट रेसिडेंस मेमोरी।